During the 1990s, every discovered exoplanet was a sensation. So far, several thousand planets have been detected around distant stars. Meanwhile, we also know that about 7% of all stars have a giant planet within 3 astronomical units, and that 20% of all stars have planets. Due to technological advancement, more and more Earth-like planets can be detected nowadays. Moreover, we know that stars that have a higher or the same number of metals as our Sun means the more likely they are to have planets. That's why, in this video, we want to introduce you to some of the most interesting exoplanets so far. TRAPPIST-1. TRAPPIST-1 is 40 light-years away from us. In this system, orbiting a low-mass red dwarf are 7 terrestrial planets, which are Earth-like planets with a solid surface and often a metallic core. Several of these planets also lie in the habitable zone, that is, in the area far enough from the star for temperatures to permit liquid water, but not so far away as to be a frozen ice planet. The name of the planetary system comes from transiting planets and planetesimal's small telescope TRAPPIST at La Silla Observatory in Chile. In 2016, 3 Earth-like planets were initially discovered via the transit method, and in 2017, NASA announced the discovery of 4 more Earth-like planets in this system thanks to the Spitzer Space Telescope. Since red dwarfs, which include most stars, are much fainter in luminosity than our Sun, the inner planets have an orbital period of only 1.5 to 2.4 days, while the outermost planet has 1 of 20 days. Because of this proximity to the star, it's probable that it's tidally locked. That means that the same side of the planet always points to the star, providing daylight, while on the opposite side, it always remains night. Nevertheless, it could be that the narrow strip in between, life-friendly conditions could prevail. Kepler-22b. Kepler-22b, an exoplanet 2.4 times Earth's diameter, was also found in the habitable zone around a star 600 light-years away in the constellation of Cygnus. As the name suggests, the planet was discovered with the Kepler Space Telescope and was the first planet in the habitable zone to be detected by the transit method. This discovery was confirmed by the Spitzer Space Telescope and the Keck Observatory. The planet needs 290 days for one orbit around the star KIC 1059-3626, which belongs to the spectral type G5 and therefore has similar properties to our Sun, even if it's a bit smaller and cooler. It's assumed that Kepler-22b is an ocean planet with a rocky core, but further observations, among other things with the soon-to-be-launched James Webb Space Telescope, are necessary to confirm this, especially since, at the moment, it's not yet known whether the planet moves on a rather circular or strongly elliptical orbit. Therefore, its mass cannot yet be estimated with certainty. Also, the question of an atmosphere is not yet clarified. Without an atmosphere, the surface temperature would be about minus 11 degrees Celsius, but in case of a natural greenhouse effect, the surface temperature could also be a comfortable 22 degrees Celsius. However, a Venus-like scenario would also be possible with a self-reinforcing greenhouse effect, providing much higher temperatures, which would greatly reduce the ease of life. Proxima Centauri B and the planet around Alpha Centauri A. As early as 1994, astronomers collecting data with the Hubble Space Telescope discovered irregularities in the motion of Proxima Centauri, the star closest to our solar system in this triple star system, at only 4.2 light-years away and a red dwarf. The irregularities occurred every 77 days, and they calculated that a body of 0.8 Jupiter masses in close proximity to the star could be responsible. 2 years later, another group of astronomers also found evidence of a potential planetary companion, but farther from the star and much bigger. But none of these discoveries could be confirmed. It was not until August 2016 that a terrestrial planet was also discovered in the habitable zone using the radial velocity method. This one has 1.17 Earth masses, according to 2020 data. Elsewhere in this system, more specifically around the Sun-like star Alpha Centauri A, which is somewhat more distant and forms a binary system with Alpha Centauri B, data from February 2021 seemed to indicate a Neptune-sized planet. This would be interesting in that it would approximate James Cameron's thoughts in his fictional masterpiece Avatar, where a life-friendly moon exists around a gas giant in the Alpha Centauri system. an exoplanet formally announced around Alpha Centauri B, turned out to be a spurious signal a few years later. It may be interesting to mention that in December 2020, mysterious signals on a frequency of about 982 MHz were received from this system at the Australian Parkes Observatory, of which nobody knows yet what is behind it. HD 209458b, Osiris. HD 209458b is unofficially known by the name of the Egyptian god Osiris and lies 159 light-years from us. This planet has two-thirds of the mass of Jupiter, but is slightly bigger due to its proximity to the star and the, therefore, heated atmosphere. Since its distance to the star is only 6.92 million kilometers, the planet needs only 3.5 days for one orbit, which places Osiris in the class of hot Jupiters. This planet became famous because its atmosphere is evaporated by the star and a kind of comet tail is formed. This is also the reason why this planet has the nickname Osiris, because according to ancient Egyptian mythology, this deity was killed by his brother Seth and cut into pieces to prevent him from rising again. Furthermore, the Hubble Space Telescope discovered large amounts of water vapor as well as oxygen and carbon in the planet's atmosphere. Later, studies with ESO's VLT also revealed that strong winds are racing across the planet at 5,000 to 10,000 kilometers per hour. PSR B1620-26b. The Methuselah among the planets has an age of about 12.7 billion years and thus has already existed a few billion years longer than our solar system, which is about 4.6 billion years old. This Jupiter-sized planet, detected by the Hubble Space Telescope, has an extraordinary history with a burned-out star and a pulsar in its neighborhood. The planet takes a century to complete one orbit and is located in the core of the ancient globular cluster M4, 12,400 light-years from us in the constellation Scorpio. A characteristic of globular clusters is the absence or low abundance of heavy elements, since they formed at a time when the universe was still deficient in them. This is because it is only during a supernova explosion of a giant star that the pressure conditions inside the stars are big enough to produce the higher elements of the periodic table. Accordingly, globular clusters might be the last place to look for extrasolar planets, since gas giants like Saturn and Jupiter also have solid cores of metals. The history of planet discovery dates back to 1988, when a pulsar, designated PSR B1620-26, was discovered in the globular cluster M4. This rapidly spinning neutron star rotates around 100 times per second and emits radio pulses like a lighthouse beaming light. Furthermore, a burned-out star, a white dwarf, with about 0.34 solar masses, was found nearby. Both objects orbit each other twice a year. A little later, in 1993, astronomers discovered the irregularities in the pulsar, which pointed to a third object. However, this object was much too small to be a star and, therefore, a planet was suspected. But at that time, a brown dwarf could not be ruled out either. So the debate continued until researchers used the Hubble Space Telescope in 2003. Now, the mass of the object could be determined to 2.5 Jupiter masses, so the object is clearly too light to be a brown dwarf. It has been said that, apparently, this planet also survived the radiation of the supernova that occurred here, as well as its shockwave. Corot 7b. This solar system is 490 light-years away from us, and the star belongs to spectral type G9V. The planet orbits 2.5 million kilometers closely around its central star, TYC 47991731, 23 times closer than Mercury in our solar system, that is tidally locked and always shows the same side to the star. On the day side, temperatures of more than 1,000 degrees Celsius prevail, while on the night side, the values can be in the minus range. The rotation period is very short, so short that a year on this planet passes faster than a day here. Yet, this is not the most interesting thing. Corot 7b also has a diameter of only 1.7 Earth diameters, a mass of 4.8 Earth masses with an average density of 5.6 grams per cubic centimeter, almost the identical value of our Earth. This planet thus belongs to the super-Earths. Researchers simulated the planet's hot atmosphere, and according to this, Corot 7b has lost its usual atmospheric components, such as hydrogen and nitrogen, but it could have clouds of sodium and potassium vapor, as has been observed on Jupiter's moon Io, and possibly even rain pebbles. Corot 7b was discovered by the Corot Space Telescope, through the transit method in 2009 and studied for months with ESO's HARP spectrograph, part of the 3.6-meter telescope at La Silla Observatory in Chile. In the process, another super-Earth, consequently named Corot 7C, was also discovered in this system. Thank you for your attention. If you like this video, watch our other videos about extrasolar planets.